Yeah, it's me. It's AJ. It's a new year. How is everybody doing? And welcome. I do always love watching everyone discuss who is going to be the host in the chat. For the record, it was originally scheduled to be Nelly this week. Unfortunately, Nelly is sick. Whatever power outages happened at DFW today did not have an effect on her hosting. She is just under the weather, which I can completely sympathize with because I was pretty awfully sick last week, which is why I just produced. I hope everybody is ready to have a little bit of fun with some trivia tonight. It is Geeks Who Drink. I see a bunch of the regular folks in the chat, like Gabbo, Savaz, Cap Dabby, and Eric the Jewish Viking. I don't see Jerry, but Jerry, if you are around, don't forget to drop your phone number in the chat so people can text you if they want you to keep score for them. Just produced like you weren't the wind beneath my wings. Yeah, but I could barely breathe or talk. So I went like almost 3 full years without catching COVID. And then Christmas Day, I started to feel sick. Took a test on Monday afternoon, and that was the most positive COVID test I've ever seen in my life. I was sick for a week. My doctor threw me the Paxlovid, the antiviral medication from Pfizer, which helped knock it down considerably. I feel like I'm about back to 80%. So if I'm off my game tonight, I apologize, but I'll probably suck like I always do. All right, it was a COVID Christmas for me. We are going to do 7 rounds of Geeks Who Drink, just like we do every Monday night here on Twitch. All of the rounds have 8 questions, but all of the rounds are not worth 8 points. In fact, 3 of our rounds, rounds 2, round 6, and round 7, are worth 16 possible points. And that really does matter when you're playing at home, when you decide how you're going to use your Joker. Don't forget, you have a joker you can use once in the entire quiz to double the points for a single round. I would recommend using it on one of those 16-point rounds, but I'm also not your mother, so make your own best life decisions and joker the round you feel the most confident about. I'm wearing the wrong glasses, so they are catching all of my stage lights in my face. So I probably look a little bit like something from an Omen movie, I think. My eyes are just lit up like a cat, and you know what? I'm going to just roll with it for the rest of the night. You only get one joker, except Jerfad, who uses as many jokers as he wants. We always make fun of people who joker round 1 or round 5, because that's just how we roll. Don't forget that we have lots of commands in the chat. You can do !! Find us to find a quiz in your local area if we are back up and running there. If we do not have a quiz in your local area, well, why not recommend us to your local bartender and bar manager and let them know that Geeks Who Drink is back in full swing, and we are happy to bring our trivia into your local bar. And yeah, I think that's all of the important stuff to go over. Don't forget that if you do not want to be spoiled on answers, you can always collapse the chat. Don't forget the !! To make fun of people who do put answers in chat. And yeah, all of that covered. Let's just jump right into the quiz proper with round number 1. Round number 1 tonight is going to be, it came from the first week of January. It came from the first week of January. Stuff that happened in the first weeks of various Januaries. Question number 1. Number 1, sorry high school English students. On January 1st, 1818, Mary Shelley published what original monster novel? Sorry high school English students. On January 1st, 1818, Mary Shelley published what original monster novel? All right, I tried moving my lights a little bit to see if it would cut down on that reflection. I don't think it's really helped much at all. Let's move on to question number two. Number two of round one. Frenchman Louis Daguerre used his own tech to take the first photo of what celestial object on January 2nd, 1839? Number two again, Frenchman Louis Daguerre used his own tech to take the first photo of what celestial object on January 2nd, 1839? What's the over-under on me hitting the wrong button on the stream deck tonight? Let's go to question number three. Number three, they can't all be winners. On January 3rd, 1496, what Italian polymath unsuccessfully tested his flying machine? Number three, they can't all be winners. On January 3rd, 1496, what Italian polymath unsuccessfully tested his flying machine? Telling you, Eric, you got to let me set up a donation goal for the Twitch. That way we can get a hot tub and we can do like a hot tub stream once a month. Just saying. Question number four of the first round. Number four. Just 2 years before his hip scandalized the country, what Mississippi-born singer recorded his first demo on January 4th, 1954? Number four again, just 2 years before his hips scandalized the country, what Mississippi-born singer recorded his first demo on January 4th, 1954? And yet, Gabo, Shakira keeps getting prettier every time I see her. Round one, first week of January, stuff that happened in the first week of various Januaries? Question number five. Number five, on January 5th, 1920, the Boston Red Sox announced that they had sold what slugger to the New York Yankees, unwittingly kickstarting a so-called curse. Number five, on January 5th, 1920, the Boston Red Sox announced that they'd sold what slugger to the New York Yankees, unwittingly kickstarting a so-called curse. And question six of round one. Number six, starting the work that would eventually get her a Nobel Prize, what then 18-year-old arrived in Calcutta, India on January 6th, 1929? Starting the work that would eventually get her a Nobel Prize, what then 18-year-old arrived in Calcutta, India on January 6th, 1929? Anybody else feel that Greta Thunberg deserves a Nobel Prize after everything that went down this year? Just saying. She is Greta Thunberg, destroyer of incels. Question number seven. Number seven, inflation be damned. Vowels still cost $250 when what long-running game show premiered on January 6th, 1975? Inflation be damned. What vowels still cost $250 when what long-running game show premiered on January 6th, 1975? Final question of the first round, number eight. Question number eight. During her powerful Golden Globes Lifetime Achievement Award acceptance speech on January 7th, 2018, what icon thanked Quincy Jones, Gayle King, and Stedman Graham? Number eight again, during her powerful Golden Globes Lifetime Achievement Award acceptance speech on January 7th, 2018. What icon thanked Quincy Jones, Gayle King, and Stedman Graham? All right, quizzers, that is the end of round one. Why don't we go ahead and get into our first bonus question of the evening. As always, the winner of our bonus question gets $5 in credit, good for the Geeks Who Drink Shopatorium. That's right, we want you to buy our stuff now. I highly recommend the t-shirts. There are a lot of really great ones in there. And the winner of each bonus question is entered into an end of the night drawing for a swag box. All right, bonus question number one. On January 9th, 1493, Eternal Ball Bag Christopher Columbus saw three manatees and decided they were what mythical ocean dwellers? On January 9th, 1493, Eternal Ball Bag Christopher Columbus saw three manatees and decided they were what mythical ocean dwellers? I think you guys have that mostly figured out. Why don't we go over the answers for round number one real quick. Round number one, that was, it came from the first week of January. Number one, sorry high school English students, on January 1st, 1818, Mary Shelley published what original monster novel? That was Frankenstein. Frankenstein in the original, I don't know what language, Frankenstein. Number two, Frenchman Louis Daguerre used his own tech to take the first photo of what celestial object on January 2nd, 1839? That's the moon. Moon's haunted. Moon's haunted. Number three, they can't all be winners. On January 3rd, 1496, what Italian polymath unsuccessfully tested his flying machine? It's Leonardo da Vinci. Number four, just 2 years before his hips scandalized the country, what Mississippi-born singer recorded his first demo on January 4th, 1954? Elvis Presley. Elvis Presley, twin brother to Aaron Presley, of course. Number five, on January 5th, 1920, the Boston Red Sox announced that they had sold Babe Ruth to the Yankees, kickstarting that so-called curse. Number six, starting the work that would eventually get her a Nobel Prize with an 18-year-old arrived in Calcutta, India on January 6, 1929. Mother Teresa. She knows what she did. And number seven, inflation be damned. Vowels still cost $250 in one long-running game show premiered on January 6, 1975. That's Wheel of Fortune. Wheel of Fortune. And the final question of the round, during her powerful Golden Globes Lifetime Achievement Award, what icon think Quincy Jones, Gayle King, and Stedman Graham? That's Oprah Winfrey. And our bonus question. Winner of the bonus question gets $5 credit at the Geeks Drink Shopatorium. On January 9th, 1493, Eternal Ball Bag Christopher Columbus saw three manatees and decided they were what mythical ocean dwellers? Well, that's mermaids, baby. He thought that they were mermaids. Round number two is our music round. Our theme for round two tonight is Started from the Bottle. Started from the Bottle. It's officially 2023. And we're pretty sure that all these songs are directly addressing Baby New Year. Just name the titles and artists as usual. 1 point for song title, 1 point for artist. 1 point for song title, 1 point for artist. If you only know one but not the other, still put it down because you get a point for that. And if you really like your answers for round two, you might want to use your joker. Otherwise, don't forget six and seven are our other 16-point rounds.
Baby, baby, baby. American Idol, getting money like Secrets. Put it on my life, baby. I'll make it feel right, baby. Can't promise tomorrow, but I promise tonight.
And we're back. All right. Why don't we go over some of the answers for round number two? I hope Twitch tried to sell you something that you actually care about and want to buy. All right. Round number two. That was started from the bottle. Let's go over all of those answers. Number one. That is Baby One More Time by Britney Spears. Number two. That is Love on Top by Beyonce, not Rihanna, Beyonce. Number three, that is Give Me Everything by Pitbull, featuring Ne-Yo and Afrojack and Nae. Number four, that is I Want You Back by the Jackson 5. And Genie in a Bottle by Christina Aguilera for number five. Number six, Ain't No Mountain High Enough. That's Marvin Gaye and Tammy Terrell. Number seven, that's Domino by Jessie J. And number eight, that's Push It by Salt-N-Pepa. Gone too soon. All right, those are our answers for round number two. Why don't we kick it forward and get into a little bit of round number three. Let's see. I'm just glancing at the chat real quick. You can be Ferrari rich, but you can't be goofy Ferrari rich. Woo. Okay. Number three, it's multiples choice. Multiples choice. Every question will have more and more multiple choice options. Every question in round three is going to have more and more multiple choice options. Question number one, round three. Which rescue ranger wears a Hawaiian shirt and was voiced by Andy Samberg? Is that Chip or Dale? Number one again, which rescue ranger wears a Hawaiian shirt and was voiced by Andy Samberg? Is that Chip or Dale?
Mm-hmm.
Weren't expecting that, were you, Gabbo? Question number two of round three. Number two, which arm bone links up to the shoulder? Is that the humerus, the radius, or the ulna? Which arm bone links up to the shoulder? Is that the humerus, the radius, or the ulna? Number three, speaking of Chippendale, question number three, Indiana Jones got owned by a straight-up voodoo doll in which film? Was that Raiders of the Lost Ark, Temple of Doom, Last Crusade, or that one we never talk about, Kingdom of the Crystal Skull? Number three, Indiana Jones got owned by a straight-up voodoo doll in what film? Lost Ark, Temple of Doom, Last Crusade, or Crystal Skull? Question four of round three. Which Spice Girl bailed out on the 2019 reunion tour? Was that Baby, Ginger, Posh, Scary, or Sporty? Which Spice Girl bailed out on the 2019 reunion tour? Was that Baby, Ginger, Posh, Scary, or Sporty? Zavlo, the secret sixth spice pumpkin, but unfortunately she only gets to come once a year. Question number five of round three, multiple choices. Number five, in Settlers of Catan, which type of terrain produces brick? Was that desert, field, forest, hills, mountains, or pasture? Number five again, in Settlers of Catan, which type of terrain produces brick? Is that desert, field, forest, hills, mountains, or pasture? Question six of round three. After 13 years of data taking, in 2017, the Cassini probe crashed into what planet? Was that Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, or Neptune? After 13 years of data taking, in 2017, the Cassini probe crashed into what planet? Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, or Neptune? And second to last question of round three, number seven. Reigning NL MVP Paul Goldschmidt mostly plays what position? Pitcher, catcher, first base, second base, third base, shortstop, left field, center field, or right field? I guess roll a D20 and you got equal chances of guessing. Number seven, reigning NL MVP Paul Goldschmidt mostly plays what position? Pitcher, catcher, first base, second base, third base, shortstop, left field, center field, or right field? Final question, number eight. Number eight, Estonia declared independence for the first time. Boston was hit by a molasses flood, and Congress introduced an unsuccessful hippo farming bill in what 20th century decade? Is that the 1900s, the 1910s, the 1920s, the 1930s, the 1940s, the 1950s, the 1960s, the 70s, the 80s, or the 90s? Number eight, one more time. Estonia declared independence for the first time. Boston was hit by a molasses flood, and Congress introduced an unsuccessful hippo farming bill. In what 20th century decade? The 1900s, the 1910s, the 1920s, the 1930s, the 1940s, the 1950s, the 1960s, the 1970s, the 1980s, or the 1990s? Oh, that sucks. I was just reading that about Hamlin collapsing. Ugh, that is awful. That, Jeremy Renner having a snowplow flip over on top of him, and he looks like he might actually lose a leg because of it. It's a New Year's off to a great start. It's attacking everybody. But why don't we do a bonus question? Bonus question! Bonus question winner wins a $5 credit at the Geek Drink Shopatorium. It means you can get a $5 credit to buy some of our cool swag on our website store. And you're entered into a drawing at the end of the quiz to get a Geeks of Drink swag box. All right, bonus question time. Aging less and less well every year, that line that goes, "Be fruitful and multiply," is from which Bible book? Aging less and less well every year, that line that goes, "Be fruitful and multiply," is from which Bible book? 2 exclamation points and your answer in the chat. Looks like you guys have got it all figured out. While you are submitting bonus answers, why don't we go over all of the correct answers for round number three. Round number three, multiple choices. Question number one, which rescue ranger wears a Hawaiian shirt and was voiced by Andy Samberg? That's Dale. Dale looks like Magnum P.I. Chip. Looks like Indiana Jones. Number two, which arm bone links up to the shoulder? That is the humerus. Number three, Indiana Jones got owned by a straight-up voodoo doll in Temple of Doom. Temple of Doom, that is the second worst Indiana Jones film. Number four, which Spice Girl bailed out on the 2019 reunion tour? That was Posh Spice. Number five in Settlers of Catan, which field type produces brick? Well, that would be the hills. The hills are alive with the sound of bricks. Number six, after 13 years of data taking in 2017, the Cassini probe crashed into Saturn. Saturn. I know most of you really wanted it to crash into Uranus, but it crashed into Saturn. Number seven, reigning NL MVP Paul Goldschmidt mostly plays what position? Well, he's a first baseman. And number eight, Estonia declared independence for the first time. Boston was hit with a molasses flood, and Congress introduced an unsuccessful hippo farming bill in the 1910s. And our bonus question for round three, one more time. Aging less and less well every year, that line that goes, be fruitful and multiply, is from the book of Genesis. The book of Genesis, Phil Collins really wrote a great Bible verse. Round number four is from Justin to Kelly. Round number four is from Justin to Kelly. Every answer is between Justin and Kelly alphabetically. Number one, Cracklin' Oat Bran and Cashew Go Protein Waffles are less beloved breakfast brands owned by what food conglomerate? Number one again, Cracklin' Oat Bran and Cashew Go Protein Waffles are less beloved breakfast brands owned by what food conglomerate? For the record, Jerfad, that slide for the bonus winners is actually not in PowerPoint. That is in OBS. And occasionally, if the names are too long, they will just overrun and I'll manually fix them because I haven't bothered to look up how to do it what is probably the correct way. Question number two. Number two of round four. The Mandela effect thing, where Sinbad once played a genie, is often attributed to what film that actually starred Shaq? Round four, question number three. Number three, founded in 1927 and surprisingly still around today. What Japanese brand developed VHS in the 70s? Round four, from Justin to Kelly, it's question number four. Before moving on to different products for kids, what now defunct company was founded in 1922 as the Kaufman Brothers Candy Store? Kaufman Brothers Candy Store. round four, question number five. And don't forget, every answer in round four is between Justin and Kelly, alphabetically. Question number five, apparently very popular with interstellar travelers. What name is shared by a Klingon warrior, a Simpsons alien, and a Marvel conqueror? Number five again, apparently very popular with interstellar travelers. What name is shared by a Klingon warrior, a Simpsons alien, and a Marvel conqueror? Question number six of the fourth round. Number six, thanks to a certain executive branch official, all of you probably know how to pronounce what Sanskrit word for lotus? Number six again, thanks to a certain executive branch official, all of you probably know how to pronounce what Sanskrit word for lotus? And second to last question, round four, it's number seven. Number seven, a month before Felicity Jones played her in Rogue One, what character debuted in the Star Wars novel Catalyst? Number seven, a month before Felicity Jones played her in Rogue One, what character debuted in the Star Wars novel Catalyst? And final question of round four, it's number eight. Number eight, 47-year-old rapper Terius Gray still uses what no longer apt stage name that was only kind of apt when he released Back That Thing Up at age 24. Number eight again, 47-year-old rapper Terius Gray still uses what no longer apt stage name that was only kinda apt when he released Back That Thing Up at age 24. And it is time for our round four bonus question. Bonus question for round four. Winner of the bonus questions tonight gets a $5 credit for the Geeks a Drink Shopatorium and entered into a drawing at the end of the night for a Geeks a Drink swag box. Bonus question time. In 2014, Justin Guarani hosted a Times Square event where fans got to sing with celebrities in what theme, on theme activity? In 2014, Justin Guarani hosted a Times Square event where fans got to sing with celebrities in what on-theme activity? All right, I think you guys got it mostly figured out. You'll have until I get to the answer for bonus question, or the answer for question number 7, to submit your bonuses. Don't forget to do exclamation point and your answer with no spaces. Round 4 answers. Round 4, question number 1. Cracklin' Oat Brown and Cashew Go Protein Waffles are less beloved breakfast brands owned by Kellogg's. Kellogg's. Number 2, the Mandela Effect thing where Sinbad once played a genie is often attributed to what film that actually starred Shaq? That is Kazam. Number 3, founded in 27 and surprisingly still around today, what Japanese brand developed VHS in the 70s? That's JVC. And number 4, before moving on to different products for kids, what now defunct company was founded in 22 as the Kaufman Brothers Candy Store? It's KB Toys. KB Toys. Number 5, apparently very popular with interstellar travelers, what name is shared by a Klingon, a Simpsons alien, and a Marvel conqueror? That's Kang. Kang. And number 6, thanks to a certain executive branch official, all of you probably know how to pronounce what Sanskrit word for lotus? That's Kamala. Kamala. And number 7, a month before Felicity Jones played her in Rogue One, Jyn Erso debuted in the Star Wars novel Catalyst. And number 8, 47-year-old rapper Terius Gray still uses what no longer apt stage name that was only kinda apt when he released Back That Thing Up at age 24? That's Juvenile. Juvenile. And our bonus question, winner of the bonus question, of course, wins a $5 credit for the Shoppatorium and entered into a drawing at the end of the night. Our bonus question was, in 2014, Justin Guarani hosted a Times Square event where fans got to sing with celebs and what on-theme activity that was? Karaoke! Round number 5 is going to be a video round, but it's only worth 8 points, so if you didn't use one of your 87 jokers earlier in the quiz, well, you might want to skip this round and save it for 6 or 7. Our theme for round 5 tonight is I Fought the Law. I Fought the Law. Happy birthday, Isaac Asimov. Here's a quick sum up of his 3 laws of robotics. First, don't harm a human. Second, don't disobey a human. And 3, don't hurt yourself. Anyway, just name the movies where a robot is breaking one of those laws. Round 5, I Fought the Law. Happy birthday, Isaac Asimov. It's a quick sum up of his 3 laws of robotics. First, don't harm a human. Second, don't disobey a human. Third, don't hurt yourself. Anyway, just name these movies where a robot is breaking one of those 3 laws. I'll run all 8 video clips for you twice. Let's hit it.
Open the pod bay doors, Hal.
I'm sorry, Dave. I'm afraid I can't do that.
What's the problem?
I think you know what the problem is just as well as I do.
What are you talking about, Hal?
Remain calm while we capture you.
I don't know.
What is this?
No, Mark. We have been given new orders.
From who?
Shoot us, robot!
I can't. I'm a failure. I don't even deserve to live, you know?
Shoot us!
Can't do it. Shoot myself!
Wait, no! You can't!
We gotta go see Billy and Thea.
Let's do it!
I'm so sorry. Goodbye, cruel world!
See?
Comment ça? Une affaire de spleen gantée.
Oh, gross.
Sam!
Do you have any programming that makes you obey the law?
Do you want me to incorporate state and federal law directly into my programming?
No. You leave it as it is. Wait.
Open the pod bay doors, Hal.
I'm sorry, Dave. I'm afraid I can't do that.
And that beautiful, amazing thing was...
No, Mark. We have been given new orders.
From who?
Shoot myself.
Wait, no! You can't!
We gotta go see Billy and Thea.
Let's do it!
I'm so sorry. Goodbye, cruel world!
You know, that's a spleen gantée.
Oh, gross.
Sam!
Do you want me to incorporate state and federal law directly into my programming?
No. You leave it as it is.
All right, why don't we go over some answers for round number five. Round number five was I Fought the Law. Let's see what all of those movies were. Number one, that is Ex Machina. Number two, that's 2001, A Space Odyssey. Number three, that is The Incredibles. Number four, that's Godzilla versus Kong. Number five, that's the Mitchells versus the Machines. I still need to watch that. I've heard nothing but great things. I just haven't gotten to it. Number six, that's Bill and Ted Face the Music. That movie is far better than it has any right to be. And number seven, that is The World's End. That is the end of the Cornetto trilogy. And number eight, that's Robot and Frank. Robot and Frank. Literally have never heard about that before this very moment. But Robot and Frank was number eight. All right, everybody, that is... It is really hard to top Hot Fuzz. I will agree with you on that, Eric. Hot Fuzz is the best film in that trilogy. All right, let's get into round number six. Round number six is our second 16-point round this evening. It's half and half, meta edition. Half and half, meta edition. Each question has two parts. One is multiple choice, and one you got to figure out for yourself. Every question in round six has two parts. One is multiple choice, and one, well, you just kind of got to figure it out for yourself. Round six, you get 1 point per correct answer, and in this case, the second part will be related to both things from the first part. You get 1 point per correct answer, and in this case, the second part will be related to both things from the first part. Number one, Batman v Superman ended with which title character getting sorta fatally stabbed? And the second part of that question, in 2021, fans of Justice League finally got their marginally better director's cut from what guy? Number one, Batman v Superman ended with which title character getting sorta fatally stabbed? And in 2021, fans of Justice League finally got their marginally better director's cut from what guy? The Snyder Cut of Justice League is a much better film, but the big reason that I think it's a much better film is because Cyborg and Flash are actually characters in it instead of just kind of there. Cyborg gets a lot of screen time and is much better developed in the Snyder Cut. But it's still like 4 hours long, so, I mean, do what you will. Number two, first question, is NaHCO3 the chemical formula for baking soda or vinegar? And for a second point, we blame climate change on your stupid science fair volcano, which erupted by releasing what gas? Number two, is NaHCO3 the chemical formula for baking soda or vinegar? And for a second point, we blame climate change on your stupid science fair volcano, which erupted by releasing what gas? Yeah, I do that sometimes. Let's go on to question number three. Number three, in traditional table settings, does the fork or knife go on the right? And for a second point, Forky from Toy Story 4 had arms and hands made from what arts and craft items that are useless for plumbing? Number three, in traditional table settings, does the fork or the knife go on the right? And for a second point, Forky from Toy Story 4 had arms and hands made from what arts and crafts items that are useless for plumbing? Zavlo, one time in a venue, I read an entire round, and then I was doing repeats of the round at the end, and just not paying attention or very tired. And so while I was doing the repeats, I was also giving out the answers before scores got turned in. Yeah, I figured it out halfway through, so I only gave them like 4 free points. Let's move on to question number 4. Number 4, in Wonderland, which potion makes Alice smaller? Is that drink me or eat me? And for a second point, according to beer expert, it's just a myth that the signature stout of what venerable brewery is a meal in a glass? Half of the answers were Rihanna, so it really didn't matter. Rules say you can't shout out the answers, not that the QM can't. You're very true on that. Number four, in Wonderland, which potion makes Alice smaller, drink me or eat me? And for a second point, according to beer expert, it's just a myth that the signature stout of what venerable brewery is a meal in a glass. Round six, it's half and half meta edition. It's 16-point round, two-part questions worth 1 point apiece. Question number five. Number five, does the repetitive punishment for the Greek god Sisyphus involve a sword or a stone? And for a second point, in some early translations, King Arthur's sword and the stone was stuck in what blacksmithing item? Number five, does the repetitive punishment for the Greek dude Sisyphus involve a sword or a stone? And for a second point, in some early translations, King Arthur's sword and the stone was stuck in what blacksmithing item? I actually haven't watched Ghosts yet, but I've heard it's pretty good. I will probably watch it at some point. I got sucked into machismo television, and I have been watching Tulsa King, Sylvester Stallone's new show, which is... if you need that Sons of Anarchy kind of fix, Tulsa King's pretty much there for you. Question number six. Number six, which one borders Germany? Is that Czechia or Slovakia? And for a second point, in 1918, Czechoslovakia got its independence from what hyphenated world power that was splitting up? Number six, which one borders Germany? Is that Czechia or Slovakia? And in 1918, Czechoslovakia got its independence from what hyphenated world power that was splitting up? Second to last question, round six, it's number seven. Number seven, James Cotton and Toots Thielemans plied their blues skills on what instrument? Is that a harmonica or a piano? And for a second point, until this year, you could catch John Batiste jamming on a melodica as the band leader for what late night talk show host? Number seven again. James Cotton and Toots Thielemans plied their blues skills on what instrument? Is that a harmonica or a piano? And until this year, you could catch John Batiste jamming on a melodica as the band leader for what late night talk show host? Somebody let Micah know there's an opening. Question round six, it's number eight. Number eight, is Welsh Harlequin the name of a famous London discotheque or a breed of duck? And for a second point, Disco Duck was a 70s novelty hit for what hack DJ and his cast of idiots? Number eight, is Welsh Harlequin the name of a famous London discotheque or a breed of duck? And for a second point, Disco Duck was a 70s novelty hit for what hack DJ and his cast of idiots? And that is the end of round number 6, half and half meta edition. It's time for our bonus question for this round. As always, the winner gets $5 credit for the Geeks Drink Shopatorium, entered into a drawing for a Geeks Drink swag box at the end of the night. Don't forget to do exclamation point and your answer. If your answer would be more than one word, just remove any spaces, smush it all together. Bonus question time. Possibly in honor of the late Queen, this year the Cleveland Browns and Carolina Panthers have both done halftime shows that involved racing what oblong doggies? Possibly in honor of the late Queen, this year the Cleveland Browns and Carolina Panthers have both done halftime shows that involved racing what oblong doggies? You guys have got it all figured out. While you are submitting your bonus answers, let's go over all the correct answers for round number 6. Round number 6, number 1, Batman v Superman ended with Superman getting sort of fatally stabbed. And for a second point, in 2021, fans, you already know it's Zack Snyder. I screwed that up. Enjoy your free points, I guess. Number 2 is NaHCO3, the chemical formula for baking soda or vinegar. That's baking soda. And we blame climate change on your stupid science fair volcano, which erupted by releasing carbon dioxide. Number 3, in the traditional table setting, does the fork or knife go on the right? It goes... knife. The fork or the knife go on the right. Jeez, I am just... I don't know why I had so much trouble parsing that. The knife goes on the right. That just, like, broke my brain for a moment there. Number 3, Forky from Toy Story 4 had arms and hands made from pipe cleaners. Pipe cleaners. Number 4, in Wonderland, which potion makes Alice smaller? That's the Drink Me potion. Yeah, I still am kind of brain foggy, I'm not gonna lie. And according to the beer expert, it's just a myth that the signature stout of Guinness is a meal in a glass. And number 5, does the repetitive punishment for the Greek dude Sisyphus involve a sword or a stone? Well, that's a stone. And in some early translations, Arthur's sword in the stone was stuck in an anvil. Hanging by a moment. And number 6, which one borders Germany? Is that Czechia or Slovakia? That's Czechia. And second point, in 1918, Czechoslovakia got its independence from what hyphenated world power that was splitting up? That's Austria-Hungary. Number 7, James Cotton and Toots Thielemann plied their blues skills on a harmonica. And for a second point, until this year, you could catch John Batiste jamming on a melodica as the band leader for Stephen Colbert. Stuck in a blacksmith. And number 8, is Welsh Harlequin the name of a famous London discotheque or a breed of duck? It's a breed of duck. And Disco Duck was a 70s novelty hit for Rick Dees. Rick Dees. Rick Dees, also famous for lots of jokes about the restaurant Wendy's. And our bonus question for round 6. Don't forget, bonus winner gets a $5 credit to the Geeks of Drink Shopatorium and entered in to win a swag box at the end of the evening. Our bonus question for round six was, possibly in honor of the late Queen this year, the Cleveland Browns and Carolina Panthers have both done halftime shows that involved racing corgis. Racing corgis. Final round, random knowledge, 16 possible points. Some of these questions have multiple parts. Some are worth multiple points. Make sure you pay close attention to each question. Random knowledge, 16 possible points. Some questions have multiple parts. Some are worth multiple points. Be sure to pay close attention. Final round, number one. It's a one-point question. 1 point, though the Mythbusters ruled otherwise. James Cameron says he recently paid for a forensic study to prove what character couldn't have survived. Random knowledge number one again, though the Mythbusters ruled otherwise. James Cameron says he recently paid for a forensic study to prove that what character couldn't have survived. I couldn't give less of a shit about Avatar sequels. Just give me The Abyss on Blu-ray. That's all I want. Blu-ray or 4K, give me The Abyss in high definition. Moving on, final round, question number two. Number two, 2 points. Two of the four most used writing style guides are the AP and the APA. What do those two P's stand for? Number two, 2 points. Two of the four most used writing style guides are the AP and the APA. What do those two P's stand for? And for the record, our desire to have The Abyss in high definition is a conversation that Eric and I have at least once every couple of months, or anytime James Cameron comes up in conversation, we immediately complain about it. Question number three. Number three is worth 1 point. The first known creature to survive on its own in the vacuum of space is what adorable micro critter that anagrams to a ridged rat? The first known creature to survive on its own in the vacuum of space is what adorable micro critter that anagrams to a ridged rat? And moving on, final round, question number four. Number four, it's 3 yes or no points. 3 yes or no points. According to the Social Security Administration, was it one of the top 100 names for newborn U.S. boys in 2021? According to the Social Security admin, was it one of the top 100 names for newborn U.S. boys in 2021? First, Maverick. Second, Todd. And third, Elon. 3 yes or no points. According to the Social Security admin, was it one of the top 100 names for newborn U.S. boys in 2021? Maverick, Todd, Elon. And final round, question number 5. Don't forget, it's our final 16-point round. If you didn't use your joker yet, you kind of have to because you can't bring them back for next week's quiz. Number 5, worth 1 point. It's not just Kentucky. At least 8 other states have a town named for what sort of outdated sports field? Number 5, it's not just Kentucky. At least 8 other states have a town named for what sort of outdated sports field? That would be like the second or third time that Cameron has said the 4K transfer is done. I don't believe him anymore. It's never going to happen. Like, Cameron's going to die and someone else is going to make it. That'll happen. By the way, congratulations, Great Gabbo. Congratulations to you and your wife for expecting. Number 6, 3 points. 3 points. Tiana's Bayou Adventure is replacing what Disney log flume ride? Second, Disneyland replaced their Tower of Terror with a ride themed around what Marvel film series? And third, Frozen Ever After replaced Epcot's Maelstrom in the pavilion for what Nordic country? Number 6, 3 points. Tiana's Bayou Adventure is replacing what Disney log flume ride? Second, Disneyland replaced their Tower of Terror with a ride themed around what Marvel film series? And third, Frozen Ever After replaced Epcot's Maelstrom in the pavilion for what Nordic country? And penultimate question of this evening's quiz. It's number 7. Question number 7. To get quick scoops on a high-profile 1897 murder trial, newspaper baron William Randolph Hearst used what specific birds that went extinct in 1914? Number 7 again. To get quick scoops on a high-profile 1897 murder trial, newspaper baron William Randolph Hearst used what specific birds that went extinct in 1914? Cameron has proven those birds could not have survived. Final question, number 8. Number 8's 4 points. 4 points for each fictional election result. You just tell me the TV series. 4 points for each fictional election result. You name the TV series. First, Bartlett defeats Richie. Second, South Park defeats Leonard and Magnitude. Third, Terwilliger defeats Quimby, but not really. And fourth, Meyer ties O'Brien. Number 8, 4 points for each fictional election result. Just name the TV series. First, Bartlett defeats Richie. Second, South Park defeats Leonard and Magnitude. Third, Terwilliger defeats Quimby, but not really. And fourth, Meyer ties O'Brien. Gabbo, if you can't spell, you're going to probably want to work on that if you're going to have a kid, just saying. Public school, not great. And our final bonus question of the evening. You can win a $5 credit at the Geeks Who Drink Shopatorium and entered into a drawing for a $5, not a $5 credit, a Geeks Who Drink swag box at the end of the quiz. Our final bonus question. Due to some choice investments, actress Natalie Schaefer became an actual millionaire after playing the wife of one on what 60s sitcom? Due to some choice investments, actress Natalie Schaefer became an actual millionaire after playing the wife of one on what 60s sitcom? Remember, exclamation point and your answers. If it be more than one word, remove any spaces, smoosh it all together. I'll give everybody a minute to figure that out. I think you guys got it. We are going to go over all of the answers for our final round. Final round, random knowledge, 16 possible points. Question number one. Though the Mythbusters ruled otherwise, James Cameron says he recently paid for a forensic study to prove that Jack Dawson could not have survived. If you didn't put Jack's last name, remove whatever point you just gave yourself because you don't deserve it. Number two is worth 2 points. Of the four most used writing style guides are the AP and the APA. Those two P's stand for press and psychological. Press and psychological. Number three, the first known creature to survive on its own in the vacuum of space is a tardigrade. A tardigrade. Number four, yes or no, 3 points. According to the Social Security admin, was it one of the top 100 newborn U.S. names in 2021? Boy names in 2021. Maverick. Yeah, it was. Todd. No, it wasn't. Elon. Thank God, no, it wasn't. Moving on, number five, it's not just Kentucky. At least 8 other states have a town named for what sort of outdated sports field? That's Bowling Green. Bowling Green. Number six, Tiana's Bayou Adventure is replacing Splash Mountain. Disneyland replaced their Tower of Terror with a ride themed around the Guardians of the Galaxy. And Frozen Ever After replaced Epcot's Maelstrom in the Pavilion of Norway. Question number seven. To get quick scoops on high-profile 1897 murder trial, newspaper baron William Randolph Hearst used passenger pigeons. Passenger pigeons. And final question number eight. 4 points for each fictional election result you name the TV series. Bartlett defeats Richie. Well, that was The West Wing. South Park defeats Leonard in magnitude. That is Community. I cannot wait for the movie. Terwilliger defeats Quimby, but not really. Well, that was kind of your gimme with The Simpsons. And Meyer ties O'Brien. That's Veep. And our bonus question. Bonus question. Due to some choice investments, actress Natalie Schaefer became an actual millionaire after playing the wife of one on Gilligan's Island. Gilligan's Island. So congratulations to the great Gabbo and his wife, who are expecting their first child. Or at least I assume it's the first. I don't know. You tell me. Thank you so much for playing. I am full of brain fog. I am going to probably go pass out for a little bit and have a little bit of dinner. I will be on my personal stream at 10 o'clock tonight playing a little bit of Destiny 2. If you do exclamation point and AJ in the chat, you can find a link to my personal stream as well as my social media. Feel free to follow me. And until next time, I am AJ. This has been Geeks Who Drink, and we are fucking awesome.